Writing completely revolutionized humanity in almost every way. We can tweet, we can write scripts for videos, and I mean, I guess that's really it, isn't it? Hey there, writers. Trace here for DNews. Thank you for watching. Language makes it so everything we do works, right? Without language, I couldn't talk to you or tell you to watch out for that predator. To put it simply, language allows me to express what's in here out here. And that is hugely powerful. It's life-changing, in fact. It's world-changing, if you really think about it. According to modern archaeology, there may have been proto-language as far back as Homo erectus and Homo habilis, more than a million years ago. But our first true verbal language probably developed between 30,000 and 100,000 years ago. So if verbal language lets me tell someone next to me what's inside of my head, writing lets me tell someone 500 miles away or 500 years from now. Writing was a major world-changing invention, first with symbols, cave paintings, and pictograms. A new study from a Canadian researcher believes that this proto-written language may be 40,000 years old. The researcher looked at cave symbols across southern Europe and found symbols repeated, indicating to her that there was likely some kind of writing system in use. There were even memes where some symbols rose and fell in popularity, indicating an overarching interest in culture. But what they meant is still a mystery. There's no context. Most archaeologists believe the first true writing was cuneiform. It was developed in ancient Sumer around 3000 BCE as an evolution of tiny pictograms. It eventually had enough contextual information to closely mimic what people were actually saying aloud, but writing it down. It was created by pressing a blunt reed into a piece of clay, allowing it to be preserved for later perusal. Modern humans, with their reading and their writing and their well, pretty much that's what they had at the time, were able to spread throughout Europe and Africa, but language does more than facilitate expression, storytelling, and coordination. When you write, your brain has to navigate those fine motor movements. It has to recall letters, words, shapes, and rules, not to mention simply see what's going on the paper, and reading and comprehending what you've written as well, and predicting what you're going to write next. It's complicated. Functional MRI scans done on the brains of writers during a study from the University of Greifswald found that brain activity was similar to professional sports stars. Using a custom-built writing desk, the researchers allowed people to write creatively while assessing their brain's blood flow, and they found that visual and speech centers lit up during brainstorming. The hippocampus activated during factual recollection. And the prefrontal cortex was active, possibly to keep storylines and characters and details straight while committing it all to paper. Our brains light up all over during the act of writing. And over time, with practice, parts of the brain learn to automate some of those processes. We don't have to practice making an A over and over again. After a while, we just know how to do it automatically. Our brains have been altered for the better, one would argue, by writing. Communicating with each other completely changed human history as well, allowing us to expand across the globe and share our best ideas with each other. According to Gallup polling, we read more now than we did 70 years ago. Thanks, Internet. And as emojis and GIFs invade our written communication, writing is still evolving. A study in emotional neuroscience found that our brains process emojis kind of like tiny little actual faces. So is the future of writing kind of the past of writing? Are we going back to the pictograms of cuneiform and earlier? Do you handwrite anything anymore? I mean, I try to, but it's really tough for my pen and paper to keep up with my brain. You can tell me down in the comments, or you can subscribe for more DNews videos every day of the week. You can also come find us on Twitter. We're @DNews, and I am @TraceDominguez.